I'm Dan, and I'm an animator who's into video games. Welcome to Video Game Animation Study. In this video, we're going to look at how Link swings a sword. Firstly though, if you find yourself enjoying the video, then please give a like and subscribe to the channel, as it really helps. Now when it comes to an action like Link swinging the Master Sword, there's a number of things a video game animator has to consider. You've not only got your 12 basic principles of animation, you've also got what Jonathan Cooper calls in his book Game Anim, the 5 fundamentals of video game animation. This is something I'll come back to in more detail in later videos, but in essence, these fundamentals consider aspects of the medium which simply weren't around during its golden age. These fundamentals don't replace the 12 principles, but rather complement them. No longer is animation purely a linear medium. You've got this whole industry where you control the flow of animation. Jonathan calls this fundamental fluidity, and we'll be considering this along with timing and a couple of other principles when studying our courageous silent friend here, and just how fluid he actually is. So, what is fluidity first? Fluidity, much like feel, is how all the animations of a character flow together. We could compare, say, Vice City with GTA 5. When turning and performing other actions in Vice City, Tommy Fassetti feels quite disjointed, and the overall feel is a bit clunky. There aren't many transitioning frames between turning, for example, and jumping snaps between animations. Whereas Franklin in GTA 5 feels super smooth, where any action you decide to do is worked into the action you're currently doing, and all your actions feel connected in this big web of information, and any changes in the flow of animation are barely noticeable. I guess you could say Tommy Fassetti has low fluidity, and Franklin has high fluidity. So what's this got to do with Link's sword swipe? How does it feel to swing away? There's a constant battle in game production between designer and artist. You might want a swing of a sword to feel hefty, powerful, and stylish, like how you'd want to do in real life. But in a game, you want this action to feel like you have control over what you're doing. So this action is going to need to feel quick, otherwise it'll feel sluggish. But you want it to feel believable and satisfying. So you have to work out which frames are essential to the action and which are detrimental to the gameplay, and remove them as necessary. Okay, so let's just get stuck in and have a look at a few swings, and go from there. So, it's a functional animation. There's nothing particularly extravagant or stylish going on. It's concise. We start with Link standing straight, and once sword play commences, he fixes himself in a more sturdy pose, keeping all that potential energy behind him for later use. So the first swipe sees him bring back the sword in anticipation. We don't linger on this pose for too long before he swings with a mere 4 frames of animation, and lingering in a follow-through pose while his tunic catches up and he steadies himself, and then he gently regains the starting pose. This phase, from the follow-through to the restart, is actually a window for a new animation to begin for a second swing. This second swing can begin immediately after the first animation has concluded, or it can start slightly later if you're not quick enough or the circumstances are different. So when this second swing starts, Link alters his arm from underarm to overarm, so that this second swing is powerful again, because swinging back towards your body underarm isn't very effective. I mean, I've never held a sword, so I don't know, but... Luckily, he doesn't need to get back into an anticipating pose because he's already in one from the follow-through of the first swing, though he does build up a bit more energy by pulling back just a bit more, and then unleashing into the next swing. He shifts his right leg a bit so he can lean into it more, and you can see the transfer of energy from one side of the body to the next. And then this is the third window of opportunity for another swing to keep the momentum. This third swing is the same as the first, except we've got a much stronger pose from the follow-through of the second swing. Link rearranges his overarm stance back to underarm so he's at an advantage, and uses his body to swing that sword. And now we have the fourth window of opportunity for a final big swing. Link this time begins the swing like his second swing, but now completely spins on the spot, dragging the sword round for a really big swipe. He finishes and lingers for a while on this pose, before regaining that original stance. Now, a couple of things. While this feels good to play and is responsive and satisfying and easy to read, how fluid is it all? Let's take a look at some of these transitioning frames. When we slow this right down, we can see that there's some jarring snaps between those different actions. And sorry, but Link is literally spinning on the spot here, which his feet aren't making happen. While this might look silly and incorrect, this is often the problem you have to solve when making flexible animations like this. If each of these sword swings were fixed animations, which all play through at the right time at the right spot, it would all feel really smooth and linear. But because we have these flexible windows of when and where the next animation starts, you have to kind of average out where the next swing will start and how it will look. What we have to consider is that while we're picking this apart frame by frame, this is not noticeable during gameplay, even the sliding feet. And this is what contributes to feel. If we did let these animations play out to the end so they all sync up correctly, then you'd have to wait for them to finish, leaving you feeling like you're not in control and breaking the illusion of immersiveness. The feeling of swinging away as Link is great because it looks good and you're in control. It's the age-old debate of form and function. Link might not be as fluid as Spidey or Franklin, but he's much more responsive in that regard, and Nintendo always put fun first. I think Link's wielding of the Master Sword and weapons generally fits nicely into the design of this game, both aesthetically and functionally. So how fluid is Link? Well, I'd give him maybe 7.5 on the out of 10 fluidity scale. And that is how to wield the Master Sword. Hey, if you like animators called Dan who talk about video game animation on YouTube, then why not head over to New Frame Plus? My buddy Dan Floyd has just made a video on Link's climbing animation, so head on over there, I'll put a link in the description, and check it out. And check back here next time when we're going to talk about the animation of Metal Slug. Thanks again for my patrons and subscribers and commenters and likers and all you lovely people. It really means a lot with all the interaction we have going on. And yeah. Love you, bye.